On Saturday morning, a slow phasing out of lockdown restrictions begins. Some islanders will happily cry freedom, but there is a very real risk that COVID-19 could still surge through our community if we are too quick to let down our guard. I discussed the phased plan and the community's response to it with King Edward's Chief of Medicine and Infectious Disease Specialist, Dr. Michael Ashton. Some people may think that this means, oh great, I can go over to Nana's and we'll all big hugs all round. Do you think that's an unwise response to these easing of restrictions?
It's an important point for everyone to recognize is that even though we're moving away from lockdown phase to the next phase, we will still need to implement the physical distancing and hand washing and protection of our vulnerable elderly population. And so as much as we love our grandparents, our parents, unfortunately, the time is not now to be doing any of the physical interaction that we normally would want to do. This is going to be difficult for family members to talk about. And for example, for my own children, although they very much want to see their grandparents, we have decided that it's not yet the right time to making visits, and certainly not the right time to be physically closer than the 6 feet that's recommended. The elderly population is very much at risk for developing a severe infection from this disease.
The low number of confirmed cases coming from our more aggressive testing may have the community feeling like we have the virus under control. From a healthcare perspective, however, the picture may be different. Testing at the government lab at Southside is self-referral based on your job. Essential workers, for example. People without symptoms are being tested, and government has told us on numerous occasions there is higher risk of a false negative if tested without first presenting symptoms. Meanwhile, the number of hospitalised COVID-19 cases has only risen.
Looking at the case numbers now, do you think you have the equipment and the human resources you need?
I think it's still early days for us to say for sure. I'm still concerned about our supply of personal protective equipment. I continue to be concerned about our number of beds and being sure that our healthcare workers are healthy and safe. When it comes to a surge, we will be just trying to keep ahead. So every bed and ventilator that we currently have will likely need to be put to use. So the difficult times are still to come, I think, unfortunately, for the hospital.
I think the mood in the community may start to relax, whereas you're saying the worst is yet to come, possibly?
We are preparing ourselves for the likelihood of a significant increase in the number of cases as the restrictions are lifted. The hope is that we continue to monitor cases closely enough that we never get close to overwhelming the system and breaching the capacity.
Does that keep you awake at night?
It is something that I think about quite a lot.